Hi, this is Chris from needlepointers.com. You may have noticed in some of my recent quilting videos that I have been creating patterns using Electric Quilt 8 software. This Sweet Bee's Baby Quilt, Woodland Friends Panel Quilt, and Snowflake Table Topper are a few examples. Before I go any further, I must make a disclosure. needlepointers.com is an Electric Quilt affiliate, which means we earn a commission on any purchases you make through our links. We are also getting paid to make this video. Please know that Annette and I would never recommend a product that we did not like ourselves. All opinions in this video are my own and they are not influenced by Electric Quilt. Electric Quilt is running a month-long Black Friday sale now. You can get 25% off all software, add-ons, books, and printables from their website. This sale includes 25% off the EQ8 software, so if you've been thinking about purchasing it, now is a great time. I purchased Electric Quilt 8 about 1 year ago and have been using it to create the patterns I listed and some others too. I must say, Electric Quilt 8 does have a bit of a learning curve to learn how to use it. I am a computer programmer by trade, and even I ended up taking a class at a local quilt shop to learn the features and how to use the software. So, if you purchase Electric Quilt 8, I do recommend that you take an online or in-person class to learn how to use it and all the features. I'm guessing you haven't seen Electric Quilt 8, so I'd like to show you a quick demo with some of the features of EQ8, and I'll show you some of the quilts I've designed. When you open EQ8, it has this first opening screen. From here, I can click Design a Quilt from Scratch. There are tabs across the top of the screen that guide you through the steps in designing your quilt. The first tab is the type of quilt, so you can pick from various different types of quilts, and this is your basic layout, and there's even an option for a custom. Today, I'll just pick a horizontal quilt for this sample. The next tab is the layout tab. Here you can pick how many blocks across and down your quilt. You can also pick the finished size of your blocks and whether you want a sashing or not. I'll do a sample of a small quilt that's only 3x3 high, and I will have my blocks 8 inches finished size, and I will not include a sashing, but if I was going to include a sashing, I can pull this open and create a sashing around my quilt. Next, go to the borders screen. Here, you can pick the number and type of borders you want to include. It defaults to having a long horizontal border first, so I'll leave that one, and it's currently set at 1 inch wide. So this will be a thin border around your quilt. I can add a second border, and we could set it as a blocked border, half drop blocks, there's selections for diamonds, and corner blocks, and even a mitered. So I can pick another just long vertical block this time, and maybe I want this one to be wider, so I can drag this out to say 3 inches. Next, we get to the fun part, the design. EQ8 comes with a library, including hundreds of designs and fabrics built in. So you can browse and select the blocks you want to use. I'll choose a few New York Beauty blocks and add them to my quilt. These blocks now appear in my quilt and I'm able to use them. I can pick one and then I can put them on my quilt. I can then rotate them in different directions. And let's set a few more blocks here. And I'll rotate that around. I can put these blocks in there and then say, let's see what it looks like if I rotate these around. So say something like that. Next, I can experiment with colors or fabrics with the Fabric Tools button. There are many fabrics that are already loaded into EQ8, or you can pick from colors to just experiment with different colors. So I can pick the different fabrics here and then use the swap color button to swap the color out for all of the same color on the quilt. So you can see it's quick and easy to just swap out your colors with different fabrics. Once you have your quilt designed, you can go to the Print and Export button. You can print out your quilt layout. You can print yardage for the different fabrics in your quilt. Since these are foundation paper piece blocks, you can print out the foundation paper piece templates. If your blocks are rotary cut blocks, you can print out your rotary cutting instructions or print your templates. You can also print your block itself. I didn't show you these tabs over here, but there's also a block work table where you can design your own blocks and an image work table where you can import images of fabrics or applique designs and design your own applique. Next, I'd like to just show you a sample of a quilt that I'm working on now. This is a quilt I'm working on for Milo, who will be going to college next year. We purchased a sampler quilt pattern from a designer, pen and paper. This here in the center is the quilt design that we purchased. This sampler quilt wasn't large enough for the size of bed I wanted to create the quilt for. So I used EQ8 to create the blocks and then add a border to make the quilt the size I wanted. And the reason I created all of the blocks in EQ8 so that we could audition different colors and color the quilt. So here's the progression of the quilt as we worked on designing this quilt with the sampler quilt in the center and adding borders around the outside and auditioning different colors to be used in the quilt. So you can see as we went along, different things changed and we got to the final quilt. So this is the final quilt that I'm creating. The center part is from the pen and paper, and we used some of the blocks around the outside. We also used these bird blocks, which is also by pen and paper, but that was a separate pattern that we had already purchased previously. So I am still using the patterns that I purchased from pen and paper to actually create all the blocks. And then I will sew different fabrics here to fill in around these blocks and create the final quilt and add the borders. Another quilt layout I designed is the Star Wars quilt. For this quilt, I had the paper piece blocks and I needed to figure out how to put them together into a final quilt. I did not create these patterns for the Star Wars blocks. These are available for free from a website, Fandom and Stitches. So once again, you can see how I auditioned different fabrics and layouts to progress to the final quilt layout that I decided to use. I finally came up with this layout, and the quilt has been assembled together and even quilted. I just have to add the binding and it will be complete. EQ8 makes it easy to audition fabrics, try a multitude of layouts, add borders, and a lot more. I could only scratch the surface with what the software can do in this video. I hope you enjoyed learning about Electric Quilt 8 quilt design software. To learn more or purchase EQ8, please click the link in the description of this video to visit our page for Electric Quilt 8. Thank you in advance for any purchases made through our links, as this helps us to be able to keep making more videos. Like and share our videos, and if you're not a subscriber, subscribe to our channel so you won't miss future videos. Visit our website, needlepointers.com, for lots of other quilting tutorials and free projects. While you're there, sign up for our free weekly newsletter so you won't miss new tutorials. Happy quilting!